Hello everyone, in this lecture we are going to learn about the protocol, which is a simplest protocol. So this is a basic protocol for noiseless channel in a reliable data transfer protocol. So it is in a simplest protocol, there is no flow control and error control mechanism. As we discussed that reliable data transfer provides an error control, bit error control, yes, but the simplest protocol is a protocol that does not provide any error control. Also, it does not provide any flow control. Flow control means a sender sends a much amount of data, but at the receiver side it cannot handle that amount of data. So to maintain that situation, flow control is used, but this protocol is also not provide any flow control. It is a unidirectional protocol in which data frames travel in only one direction, from sender to receiver only. Yes, receiver does not send any data to the sender back. So this is a one directional process. Also, the receiver can immediately handle any receive frame with a processing time that is small enough to be negligible. And so if receives any data frame from any sender, so receiver without thinking accept that packet with a little processing time. The protocol consists of two distinct procedures, first for sender and second for receiver procedure. The sender runs in the data link layer of the source machine and the receiver runs in the data link layer of the destination machine. No sequence number, no acknowledgements are used here. Yeah, so till now we have learned many things which requires the acknowledgement to the sender, yes, for receiving data packets correctly or not. Because this is the simplest protocol, basic level protocol, it just designed to send the data packets. There is a no acknowledgement is given here, no sequence number is given here. So we can assume that the data packets received at the receiver side may be not in the order. So that is all the concept of simplest protocol. This figure shows the flow of simplest protocol. So there is no need for a flow control in this scheme. The data link layer at the sender side gets data from its network layer, makes a frame out of the data and assigns it to the receiver. The data link layer at the receiver side receives a frame from its physical layer and extracts the data from the frame and delivers data to its network layer. The data link layers of senders and receiver provides transmission service of their network layers. The data link layer used the service provided by the physical layer, such as signaling, multiplexing and so on, for the physical transmission of bits. So this figure shows this concept. Here we can see that the protocol is lies on the data link layer at the sender side, same as the receiver side. The protocol is also lies in the data link layer. So mainly it is work from data link layer. Now the next is a flow diagram for the sender. This is the simple overview of protocol. The procedure at the sender side is constantly running. There is no action until there is a request from the network layer. So the procedure at the receiver side is also constantly running, but there is no action until notification from the physical layers arise. So this is something like that. One PC is constantly running, and if it get the message, then it reacts. Otherwise, it is running on the idle states. So it is a very simple. The sender sends a sequence of frames without even thinking about the receiver. To send three frames, three event occurs at the sender side and three events at the receiver side. So note that the data frames are shown by little boxes here. The frame one, this box is shown as a frame, and the height of the box said that this is a transmission time to transmit that packet to the receiver. So in this figure, we can assume that here the sender A will keep sending frames without maintaining the flow control or the error control to the receiver. As shown above, these three frames are sent already while receiver B is processing it the first frame. Yes. So here, when it is processing its first frame, these three frames is constantly sending to that receiver. The sender works is get to data, make a frames and send a frame. And receiver works is receive frames, extract the data and deliver that data to the receiver. This is the work of this protocol. So that is all about the simplest protocol. So this is also asked in the GTU examination also. So that's it about the today's lecture. Thank you so much for listening. Have a great day.